Welcome to the Builder's Ladder with Marty Amos and Owen Chambers, the show for residential building company owners and general contractors wanting to make more money and buy back your time and build a business worth owning. We share what's working right now for the top 5% of residential building company owners and general contractors so you can implement it into your business. You either win me or win.
Win, 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 win. Yeah. Fuck everything else. Win, win, and we're live. Win. What is up? Mr.
Hey.
Amos, how you doing?
Good, my man. Great to have you here.
I know. We're in person.
Who would have thought?
That's what's up. So, we've got a podcast studio. We're going to get right into the meat and potatoes today. And what we were going to discuss was everything around marketing, because what we're seeing a lot at the moment is people saying, I'm running out of leads, I'm running out of work. We're booked out till maybe June, July, August, September, but not a lot beyond that. Where do I get my leads from? How do I do this? And honestly, the horse is kind of bolted if you have taken your foot off the gas, you stop marketing and you need something really soon. But I'm not here to tell you I told you so. We're here to actually help people out. So let's unpack the marketing strategy and what you can do short term, mid term and long term to fix your pipeline and track the right kind of work for you. So, you know, take us away from like the strategy perspective of marketing, and then we can unpack some of the specifics of what we get our members to do.
Yeah, 100%. So the key thing is to become the preferred builder in your area, and it's to engender know, like, and trust with your prospects. So people have some concerns before they choose a builder, and choosing a builder for is typically the biggest investment of anyone's life for a new build or a large renovation, and that's what most of our members are doing. So it's a highly intangible service as well, because most people haven't built a new home before or done a large renovation. So they're unsure of what lies behind the curtain. So we want to pull back the curtain and we want to show them all the systems and processes that we have on the inside that can help make their dream become a reality. Because we've all heard of the, you know, the fish hooks and the builder went bust and he's gone under halfway through the job, or he's bought a new Ford Ranger. So we want to put the client's mind at ease. And there's four key questions that we, as the building company owner, need to answer before we get to the client's five main concerns. So those four key questions are, who are you? Who's your company? Can I trust you? And how specifically can you help me?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So like usually what we're wanting to do is really plug those questions first before we focus on any traffic. So where most people go wrong is they run out of leads and they go, I need leads. I'm going to market. I'm going to spend some money on Facebook, Google AdWords, Instagram, site signage, vehicle signage, you know, sponsorship at the local sports club. Like they go to all those traffic strategies first.
Yep.
And that's the biggest mistake that I
absolutely
see. Because if they just go there and they whack their logo up, or they put their sign up, or they run some traffic to a shitty website, then
100%.
Where's the leads?
100%.
Can you hang my door? Can you do my pergola? Can you, you know, build the deck out the back?
And if you are at that, so before we get into that, the buyer waterfall or buyer's pyramid, there's two aspects. There's traffic and conversion.
Yeah.
And conversion is everything from, have you answered their key questions? Have you demonstrated trust? Do you have a video, a how we work with you video behind the doors, what we do on a site visit, what the next steps are, how we actually price your project, how we work with our sub-trades, who are our sub-trades, who are our suppliers that are actually going to be working with you on site. Who's the team that's going to be in your house during your reno? How does the owner work? When are you going to be having regular project management meetings? Mm. What's going to happen each week on site? And are you using BuilderTrend or Co-Construct to liaise with me and communicate with me each week?
Yep.
So these are all questions that everyone's got floating around in their mind. So before we drive traffic, we want to make sure that we've got these answered, and these are answered specifically through the marketing pillars. So we want to answer, what are those key five concerns that everyone has before doing a building project of any sort, whether it's a reno, a reclad, custom new home, or whatever. So people have five key concerns that we as the builder must address and show the systems that we have behind them. So they are budget, quality of work, communication, trustworthiness, and
timeline. Yeah.
Can it be done in a timely manner? Will it be finished on the date that you say that it will be? So there's a lot of specific strategies for each of those ones. So how do you demonstrate quality of work? Well, the first thing is case studies, video testimonials, before and after, master builders awards that you've won, industry associations that you belong to, your workmanship guarantee, any of your supplier guarantees. So we want to be putting these A on your website, B in the information pack that you send out, like a wow pack, and people go, wow, holy shit. Mm-hmm. We're seeing ABC Building Company next Tuesday, and shit, before they arrive, we got this courier pack. Mm. And in the courier pack was some supplier brochures, an information pack about the company and its history, and a cover letter of exactly what the process is, what they're going to do on the site visit, what they're going to do to price the project, who their suppliers are, and how they're going to liaise with their subtrades.
Yep. And the money is made in all that detail, right? So your ability to command a good margin and work with the people that you want to do projects with is all around making sure that you educate those people with all these details.
Absolutely.
So when we say, if you're lacking in leads and you need to turn on your marketing taps, and when we say focus on your conversion first, that means don't go out and buy traffic, don't go out and turn the marketing taps on and pour all this marketing money into a bucket with holes in it. Yep. We're talking about plugging the holes of the bucket first with all of the answers around these four questions and these five concerns. Who are you? Who's your team? How can I trust you? And how specifically can you help me?
Yep.
I've got concerns around timeline, budget, trustworthiness, quality, and communication. And to answer these questions and satisfy these concerns, we need to have the video testimonials, the before and afters. I mean, the list is as long as your arm.
Yep.
You should go and look at some of our members' examples of them.
Yep. And we have a free guide, like the website, totally. Ultimate website checklist guide.
Mm-hmm.
If you've got a website that isn't delivering leads every day, or you're getting all these shitty low-level maintenance, bathroom, build a deck, build a fence, mm-hmm. build a pergola, then have a look at this. Go and get video testimonials and case studies from your best clients, the ideal avatar that you want to attract. Nail down a How We Work With You video. So there's a specific structure for that. Put details on your About Us page. Who is standing behind the company? Why are you in building? What's important to you? What industry associations do you belong to? Who are your suppliers? Who are your strategic alliance partners? Shed light on what's the actual process that you go through from first getting in contact with them to handing over the code of compliance and the keys for them to move back into their new build or into their newly renovated home.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And the reason that a lot of this is important is because it'll allow us to not need to get a lot of leads, because we'll be able to convert better the leads that we already have in our pipeline.
Exactly. We're going to drip feed and educate them over the next 3, 6, 9, 12 months.
Mm.
The problem is, if you're thinking, holy shit, I've only got a runway of like 6 weeks' work.
Yeah.
The horse is bolted, and we'll get to some quick fix strategies. But typically at that stage, you are competing against two or three other builders.
Yeah.
You're being price checked, and you're competing on price to win a job. And typically, we haven't had a chance to educate them around the key other pillars, the process, the projects, and our people, and they're taking price as the main key variable.
Yeah.
So unless you want to have those Daihatsu, Mitsubishi drivers, you know, those type of clients, mm-hmm. then that's what's going to happen. But if you put the marketing pillars in place, you drive good traffic to a high converting website, a killer info pack, and have a great sales process, then we're going to help educate and nurture those people, because 5% of people are ready right now. We'll put those people through the process, but the real money is in the 25% of people who are still 3, 6, or 12 months away from doing their project. That's where we want to start educating them.
100%. So the goal in this mid to long-term solution, which is answering these four questions, satisfying these five concerns, building out all these marketing pillars that we've spoken about and that we've got a checklist for online, you can go grab it, is at the bottom of the authority pyramid, you've got the generalist.
Yep.
And that's the jack of all trades, the master of none, no job's too small. And look, there's a place in the market for people like that, but if you listen to this podcast and you're engaging with our stuff, then you're probably looking to be a little bit more of the levels above this.
Exactly.
Because what's going to happen at that generalist stage is you're going to typically be competing on price, and you're often going to be running around doing small jobs, which, as we know, there's like equal amount yep. of work in the big jobs as there are in the small jobs dealing with clients.
Just as many subtrades doing a bathroom as there is doing a full project.
Nightmare, right? So what we want to do is we want to graduate from the generalist to the specialist.
Yep.
Okay.
Absolutely. So are you the guy who solely does villa renovations that have got a higher labor content than Ponsonby? Easy to get case studies, easy to get testimonials. You become the go-to expert in that area. And that really allows your team to dial in who's best for each of those parts.
Mm-hmm.
You can control your work in progress and your labor, which is 80% of the success on a project, and you can get really dialed in that niche, in that area, and just be able to command a premium and be the go-to guy where, like,
exactly.
for my $1 million reno in my Brown Street, Ponsonby Villa, I'm willing to wait
totally
until I get Villa Renovation Expert.
100%. So the second level above generalist is specialist, and that's where you, funnily enough, specialize in a type of project. Yep. And that's often actually like what most people do try and do, mm-hmm. right? They do try and make that step.
But they need to go to that third level and become the authority.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the authority is a specialist, but the authority publisher goes from just being another builder trying to sell you their services to being the trusted advisor.
Yeah.
And the trusted advisor educates and nurtures people for the biggest high-risk investment of their life on how they can mitigate that risk, how they can make sure it's done on time, make sure that it's going to be done to budget. Do you have a killer guarantee that says, hey, your renovation will be finished on the day that we say, so let's say it's 12 weeks from now, and for every day that we're over, excluding any changes that you or the architect have made, we will pay you $117 for every day that we're late.
Mm.
So that gives, let's say even your...
It's risk reversal, right?
Exactly.
You know, it's like, oh.
We stand behind what we're doing.
Totally.
We put our face, our names behind here,
mm-hmm.
video testimonials, case studies of similar clients. And hey, if it goes 3 days, let's say it goes 3 weeks over, worst case.
Yeah.
15 days, working days, times that, let's make it $120 because I don't like doing public maths. So 15 times 120...
Bro, you got yourself into this one.
$1,800. So that means that you're out $1,800. But I can guarantee you, you're going to dial in with your timeline, with your foreman and your project manager, exactly how you get closer to within that 5% of labor hours. And you're going to be very clear for the next project that you do. And it's going to give absolute confidence to your prospects. You're going to be able to land jobs at a higher margin, with greater confidence, less price resistance, and you're going to build some great testimonials that other clients are going to be in demand for.
100%. So the authority is the third layer of the pyramid, mm-hmm. and that is where you really should non-negotiably be, right?
Yep, like, absolutely.
So being a specialist is no longer really good enough anymore because everyone's a specialist nowadays. You need to genuinely be the trusted advisor, and that is where all the marketing pillars that we're talking about come into play. Educating the market, make it really clear. But once you've got that in place, the next step is to go to the local celebrity level.
Yes.
And that's where we've got many members that sit there, and that's where you're able to command the best margins, work with the best clients on the best projects, and in this market, really key, attract the best team members.
Absolutely. And when you're booked out 6 to 12 months in advance with great projects, you've attracted great team members. You're not stressed about winning a job or competing on price just to keep you guys busy because you've got all that forward work booked in and it's at a great margin. So you got a choice. You can either lurch from feast to famine and stress and then do the work and scramble to get projects and compete on price and complain, or you can put the work in to build a bulletproof sales and marketing machine that gets you booked out with quality work for 6 to 12 months at 20% plus, 25% plus GP, that allows you to be able to choose the kind of clients you want to work for, and that also we're not just competing for clients, we're now competing for team members as well. So we want to be able to build a sales and marketing machine that attract A-grade chippies, great carpenters, and great QS project manager as you grow and build your business.
Yep. So far, if you're looking for work, get a time machine and go back and work on your conversion, then focus on traffic, be the authority or the local celebrity so that when people come to you, they go, yo, Marty, don't care what it costs or how long I have to wait, I really want you to build my project because I've seen your case studies, I've seen you around town. You've got
a killer guarantee. Yeah. I've talked to a couple of neighbors.
Exactly. Yep. I see you everywhere and I want you to do that project. So get a time machine, go back and fix that. And if you're in a position where you've already got leads and you're booked out, then this is the time for you to go harder, put your foot down and actually secure that market domination so
exactly.
that you can continue to build a really resilient and successful business over the next 3 to 5 years with an exceptional pipeline of projects. But there will be people watching this today and listening, and they will be like, sweet as, sounds great, Owen and Marty. Thanks for publishing this today and not 6 months ago when I fucking needed it.
Yep.
So what should they be doing? If you've got a gap in the pipeline right now, there are some both marketing and other mindset and systems and cash flow things that you should really be addressing right now to fix that gap.
Absolutely. So there's a shitload of them that you can do. Let's start with some simple ones. So the first one is what we term our Facebook quick grab strategy, and that's going to get you a flood of leads in the next 30 days. And I think, Owen, you're probably the best one to shed some light on.
Yep. So what we do is we geofence an area. We set a daily budget. We get a really clear offer, like a building bundle, a renovation audit, a
dreams to reality session, exactly. Renovation calculator.
Exactly. And there are then three main areas that we focus on really clearly. It's our cost per lead. Mm-hmm. Okay. It is our speed to lead, and it is our number of site visits had. So
exactly.
Cost per lead is total ad spend divided by how many qualified leads you generate. Okay.
So for $2,000, mm-hmm. you should be able to get at least 5 quality projects to price. So now you're looking at $400 per lead. Mm-hmm. Let's say you get in front of 10 people, so it was $200 to begin with, cost per lead. You've then pricing 4 of those, so you decided 3 or 4 of them weren't a good fit, a couple of others, they were too long away, and there's 4 projects worth pricing. You might then put in your price for those 4, you win 2, your cost per client acquisition is now $1,000 for each of those projects. Now, let's say they're smaller projects and they're 100K, then you've just got a return of 100 to 1 for that project. So then your gross margin, say 20% on that, $20,000. Mm-hmm. We've got a fantastic return that is infinitely scalable if we want to do that. So we can increase our margin if we want. If we've got plenty of work booked out, then we want to start pricing work at 22%, mm-hmm. 24%, 25%, and make sure that you get paid what you're worth so you can build a great business, attract a great team, and retain those team members.
Yep. So the second one is then our speed to lead, okay? Mm-hmm. So speed to lead is same day, next day. It's 24 hours. So many times I've spoken to members and they've run this strategy, they've got some leads in, I go, awesome, how'd the conversation go? Oh, I haven't spoken to them yet.
Yeah.
So, bro.
Because I've got 30 leads, they're sitting there, they're procrastinating on getting back to them. And that's where if you have a very simple process dialed in, you have an office manager, and we've actually got this in Hayden's 10-step sales process, the exact scripts, how to go back to people, and how to insert your charging quotes in there.
So it's 3-2-1. It's a 3-2-1 process, right? You must, in the same day, next day, next in the 24 hours that lead comes in, you need to set up a notification for this. You go, 3 calls, 2 texts, 1 email, non-negotiable, right? You must try and call them 3 times. You must text them twice, and you must email them once, minimum. That's the 3-2-1, same day, next day.
The whole key in doing this is who, not how. Mm-hmm. So we want to delegate this to an office manager, your significant other, your wife, your in-house QS, your fuck, even some of our members have got VAs doing half the VA QS, VA project manager, VA virtual assistant doing this. And you can get a VA like Brad has taught this system from Sydney to our members. Like, it's an absolute game changer. You can get a VA for like $250 a week that will solely deal with getting back to these leads in a timely manner with the scripts, with a phone call.
Yep.
To position them for a site visit for you if they pass your criteria.
Exactly. And then the third part, the third success criteria on this quick grab lead strategy is making sure that you do your site visit correctly. So, and this is almost deserves an episode entirely on its own, and how you choreograph that site visit from the selections checklist that you go through the client, the framing up at the beginning of the site visit that, you know, you'll be making a decision at the end of whether or not we can price and estimate your job, pitching your professional services as your preliminary service agreement,
how projects management's going to work, who's going to be in your house, how your payment schedule's going to work, how the milestones are going to work, etc.
And before you even show up, you should have sent them your info pack, and you should have tagged in 1 or 2 things. So the point is, if you've got a hole, option one or strategy number one should be going after the quick grab lead strategy with a geofence targeted Facebook ad with a really clear offer.
2 other very quick strategies that I would do on that is, number one, I would send your info pack out to 10 architects. So we've got a script on how to follow up the architects. So they all have work on the go at the moment. And ideally, you want to be quid pro quo. So you want to be referring them some work as well.
Yep.
The next key thing that you can do is BNI. So if you're in a local networking group, I highly recommend that you have a system for Business Networking International or Chamber of Commerce where you go along, you promote your business every week. It's basically like you've got 25 other sales reps for you out there looking for work. They're going to have people in their network right now that have got projects that they want done. Mm-hmm. They can tide you over until you get this marketing machine in place. And lastly, I would put in place the 1% referral system. Mm-hmm. And the 1% referral system can be applied by postcard. You can go to schools. You can have your team put it out. And it's where you will give 1% of the contract value once signed to the person who refers a project. So if someone refers a 600K project, you're going to build that into the margin. So it's going to be 606K. They get the $6,000 once the project gets signed off, deposit paid. You get the client at a higher rate typically, because we all know that anyone that comes via referral, more trusted, easier sale, less worry about concerns of are they going to bugger off. That's a much better sale.
Yep, totally. So just to recap, you've got the quick grab leads strategy on Facebook. You've got the Dream 100, which includes our 10 architects, 10 past clients, 10 team members, 10 accountants, 10 mortgage brokers, real estate agents, whatever. We want to find 10 people in 10 categories that we can go out and do the 1% referral process with, and we can ask for a referral. You then got your 9-word email. We should be going back to every single past project that never completed or like got to contract signed and the project getting underway. We should send them a 9-word email.
I've got a fucking great idea. Instead of, it's like, sounds great, but I can't remember half that shit or how do I do it? What if we did a quick grab bundle and put together those 3 or 4 key strategies that we've just said so that you can literally see how this works, plug it into your business, and let us know how this has worked for you. Everything works and nothing works. Everything will work if you put your heart and soul into it, you delegate it to someone else, you do the 10-80-10 rule of you set it up, they do 80% of the donkey work, and then you do the last 10% of quality control and the iteration. So I think we could put a fast grab lead strategy together for people.
Yeah, easy. So that 9-word email, super simple. Hey, Marty, how are you progressing with your project? ? So short, simple, expecting a reply. You send that out to the people that never turned into a contract signed. And I guarantee you're going to get replies back and conversations started again. So short term, you got to attack the problem, own the solution.
Yep.
We've got to really start marketing. The number of jobs that you sign is proportional to the number of offers you make. The number of offers you make is proportional to the number of jobs that you quote, right? So what we want to do is we want to make sure that we really attack that. Then mid to long term, you want to really go after being that authority and that celebrity in your local community and making sure that you can attract the right kind of projects from the right kind of people. So this has been helpful. Leave us a review. Tell us that it hasn't been. And you can get your hands on that quick grab lead strategy stuff. We'll have it all in the links below. Otherwise, thanks all very right. much, Marty.
Chahu.
So good.
All right. Get out there and smash it. Cheers, guys.
See you next time.
That's it for today's episode. Tune in every week if you want insights into what's working right now for the top 5% of residential building company owners and general contractors. There's 4 ways we can help you. 1, join our free Facebook group for tips, processes, best practice. 2, go to www.theprofessionalbuilder.com to download some resources, look at case studies, see what's possible for your business. 3, schedule a one-on-one chat. We'll have a 15-minute chat, see what we can do to help take your business to the next level. No obligation, we'll give you plenty of tips. And lastly, get a copy of the new book that's come out to help make your business more profitable. Cheers.